The rule.
Joining me live, fresh off an airplane from D.C. in our WGN studios this morning, the only Democrat to vote no on yesterday's stopgap measure, Congressman Mike Quigley from Illinois' 5th District. Congressman, welcome back.
Thank you.
I know you're on very little sleep, but I have to ask you, you were the sole no vote. Why?
We can't let a sovereign democratic country get wiped off the face of the earth. Democracy is on trial. The world is watching, and that includes Putin, that includes Beijing, and this was not the time. Understand what they see here is that we took Ukraine funding out to continue to function. It sent a loud and clear message, not just to Putin and Beijing and to Zelensky, but to our allies. It was a bad day.
If your vote had been needed, if Hakeem Jeffries had come to you and said, Congressman Quigley, we need it, would you have done it?
I said, you don't need my vote. There is a clean CR in the Senate, and there was at that exact moment. And it included Ukraine funding. In addition, we had time, and we also didn't need those votes on the Republican side. The night before, there was a vote just on funding Ukraine. And the about 100 or so Republicans that voted for that bill voted for the ability to keep the government open. So in the end, we could have kept Ukraine funding in and passed this. They didn't know that at the time, but I had a pretty good idea.
Your fellow Democrats who did vote for it, Congresswoman Jen Schakowsky issued a statement saying this was not only a victory for Democrats, but most importantly for the American people. Is that right? Can both things be true?
Well, look, she was right in saying it, but knowing no one should declare victory. This is all degrees of losing. Let's look at the track record recently. In June, we barely escaped crashing the markets and our economy by not raising the debt ceiling. And last night, we almost shut down the government, and we took out funding to Ukraine at the most critical time in the war. And we only did this for 45 days. So that's not a victory. And I know people worked hard to avoid the catastrophe that would have been there. But in the final analysis, nobody looking at this grading on a curve gives us an A.
If the funding had been for, if the Band-Aid had been for a shorter period of time, could you have lived with that in terms of removing Ukraine funding?
Sure, because maybe 14 days if they promised to put the bill on the floor as soon as we come back to fully fund Ukraine.
It started there, by the way, didn't it?
Well, that's right. Oh, look, and 3 days ago or so, we actually had it. We passed a bill out of the House. Unanimous support from Democrats, half the Republicans. And so, again, the Reagan doctrine and the Republican Party is dead.
Zelensky was recently on Capitol Hill. President Zelensky, did you meet with him directly? Did he give you a message?
I met with President Zelensky last July in Kyiv, and then when he was here late last year. We didn't get a chance to meet this year because of schedules. I am due to go back to Kyiv shortly.
So this process starts again. They've got 45 days to get it together. There's a lot of values that went into a vote like this. I don't see anybody changing their values. What happens in 45 days?
Well, within that time, they vote to ouster the speaker. That will fail. The question is, how much does that slow down the process? But the votes are there to fund the government for a year out of the Senate and the House, with Ukrainian funding, with disaster relief, and everything else that we need to do. It just takes the speaker willing to risk his gavel, as he started to do Saturday. It's sort of rom-com logic. They're just not into you. They're never going to love you. You might as well get over it. The day of reckoning is coming. The American people need you to do it.
Let me just, what is the practical impact of 45 days without funding? I mean, are there sort of leftover funds that can be used? What will we actually experience?
Well, in terms of Ukraine, yeah. There's enough, you know, the DOD told us that the transfer of materials will continue, right? But some of those funds will be depleted, including the replenishment fund for our own stocks. Another reason that this was a bad idea. So the Pentagon can play with this a little bit and finesse it. But one of the reasons I voted no is we're going to be right up against it in 45 days. This is because, of course, we always wait till the last minute because we have some hankering for brinksmanship.
Are you a no vote going forward? You can't necessarily predict, but 45 days from now, if you're not seeing what you like, would you do the same thing again?
We have 45 days. And we have the votes.
Well, you all had 45 days this last time, too.
Sure. It makes no sense not to do this. I'm heartened by the universal sense of support. that people yesterday were very emotional on the floor voting no, and that they seem unified. The Republicans I talked to, the 102 or so that are for Ukraine funding, said we're going to get this done. I believe them.
So closure avoided. Life will go on. Americans have short memories. We'll not worry about the fact that this almost happened. But I am curious, going through all of this, is there any effect you think this has as we move towards a 2024 election process, which is already underway? What kind of impact do you think voters will feel in all of this?
I'd like to think that they start voting for people who want the government to function. And they like people who are willing to compromise and move in the middle. The centrists on the Democratic and Republican side. There's enough of us there to do this. I hope they pay attention. I also hope they understand Fiona Hill a couple years ago said this kind of polarization and dysfunction has a national security implication. I hope they recognize we are less safe as a country because we have this polarization. And this is a new version of it. This has a far right extreme that really wags the dog.
Congressman Mike Quigley, thank you so much again for coming literally almost from the airport right here on No Sleep. We appreciate your time. Thank you, sir.